live in the rotunda at River Bluff High School, joined with Hodges McCathern. Hodges, what you got to say today on Gator Game Day?
Well, it's a great day to be a Gator. That's all I got.
That's all you got.
Awesome.
Jack Dunning here.
Yes, Jack Dunning, you know me. Gator Game Day, rated 5 stars by Coach Reynolds, that guy. He says, Dabo does not support children.
Thank you, Jack. We're also joined here with Weston Grant, who does all stats and does all of our commentary for the Gator games. Weston, how's it feel to be here today?
Excited. I'm ready to talk some stats for the River Bluff Lexington game. Can't wait.
Awesome.
We are so excited. We started yesterday, and the Wildcats came to the Swamp, and they swept them once again, boys. They came in. The closest set was the first set, and then after that, we were cruising. I'm here live with Sarah Lawrence. Sarah, you had an incredible game last night.
Thanks, Connor.
Lots of just, you're just killing the ball every single time, Sarah. And I just want to know, because last night, I'll admit, Sarah, last night was different. It was different, and I could see a different look in your eye. What did you eat before that game yesterday?
I had some Chick-fil-A.
Okay. What'd you get from Chick-fil-A?
The 8-count nugget meal, large fry, and large Coke.
Okay.
Coke, a little unorthodox for game day, but.
Yeah, that is. I was thinking the same
ball
thing, Jack.
Ball don't lie.
I'm not going to lie, though. After you telling me that, I might go have to get that Friday before the Lexington River Bluff game. Sarah, something's different about this team this year. What do y'all have to do to continue to keep winning the rest of the season?
You know, just know where we're supposed to be on the court, stay disciplined, and just play as a team.
Sarah. That's a great response. Thank you so much for coming on Gator Game Day today. We are live here with a ton of crowd. Crowd, if you're here, make some noise. It is an awesome experience here today. Now we are going to move in and talk a little bit of stats for this week's Lexington versus River Bluff football game. So, Weston, can you provide some stats for us?
So, we've got the Gators coming in with a record of 6-1, and the Wildcats come in at 5-1.
All right.
The quarterbacks are both pretty solid. For the Gators, you have Parker Murray with 737 yards passing and 9 touchdowns. And then for the Wildcats, Tayden Mines with 1,151 yards passing and 12 touchdowns. We all know that this is going to be a battle of the running backs. Two stud running backs for each side. We got Cooper Johns, the 1,088 yards and 15 touchdowns, averaging 8.3 yards a carry. That's pretty good.
That is pretty good.
On the other
shout
side,
to Cooper.
Other side, we got Jonah Norris. He's also really good. 1,171 yards rushing and 15 touchdowns. He recently just received a preferred walk-on from South Carolina, so congrats
nice.
To him.
Shout out to Jonah Norris. I'm sure
good
he's
stuff,
watching.
Man. Keep up the good work.
We've got a great trio of running backs at River Bluff. That also includes Gray Herring and Torian Leapheart. Mm-hmm. I think they're one of the best in the state.
I would agree with you there, Weston. I think that it is going to be a battle of the running backs this week, and whoever can stop the running back is going to win the game, Weston. So I appreciate you providing mm-hmm. the stats for today. We're now going to move into a segment where we are going to ask the students of River Bluff High School their score predictions for this week. So if anyone would like to tell us what the score prediction is this week, come on to the mic.
Hey, you, come here. All right.
We're live here.
What is your name?
Walker.
Walker who?
Godwin.
Walker Godwin. What do you think the score this Friday night will be at Lexington High School?
34-15.
Who's going to win?
Let's go!
Yeah! That's only correct answer.
I need another guy. Come on, man. You can come on to the show. What's your name, man?
Ethan?
Okay. Nice to see you here, Ethan. We are going to ask you, what do you think the score is going to be this week at Lexington High School?
20-32.
Who's going to win?
You.
River Bluff goes!
River Bluff, 2-0.
River Bluff wins, 2-0.
You can't reject the mock fans' draft and their scores, the mock scores.
So the Gator fans are in the rotunda. They think the Gators are going to win, but we're going to move into what Bear thinks because the only thing that matters is what Bear thinks. So, Bear, what are your predictions for this week?
He's got a whole board. All right.
So, we got some lines here for the Region 5 matchups this week. I'm going to start this week from – I'll work bottom up. Chapin is on bye. Bye is favored by 10.5.
Brutal.
Got to give it to bye. Bye's going to cover the spread.
I do think the bye week is going to probably take this one away.
I'm also going to take bye with the over.
Weston, what do you think this week?
Bye's a tough matchup. I got them.
It is a tough one. I got bye too.
Over 44, I'll take the bye any day.
All right, moving on to White Knoll versus Dutch Fork. Dutch Fork's played all around the country this year. Played teams from Maryland, Georgia, Florida. I mean,
they have.
They're trying to look for anybody they got. White Knoll coming off a tough loss last week against the Gators.
Really tough one.
This guy.
They don't want to go to 0-2 in the region, but I think they do. Mm-hmm. But I believe they'll cover the spread. I see it being like a 35-14 game. Maybe
35-14. I think that's good.
Scores a late touchdown to cover. But Dutch Fork's definitely winning, but White Knoll's going to cover, so that's where
I think I'm going to give White Knoll keeping Dutch Fork under 35. I think their defense, I think they have a pretty solid defense, and I think that they're going to keep Dutch Fork to 28 this coming Friday, and I think White Knoll's going to put 14, and I've got the final score being White Knoll 14, Dutch Fork 28.
I'm taking Dutch Fork money line all day. Dutch Fork's dropping 49 on White Knoll. I agree, though. Late touchdown, I think, is coming, but only the late touchdown. 49-7, Dutch Fork Silver Foxes.
Yeah, I'm with Jag. I just can't bet against Dutch Fork. Mm-mm. Too many state championships for that.
And the big one of the week.
The biggest game of the year, Hodges.
It is River Bluff versus Lexington. River Bluff is favored by 3.5, comes into the litter box as a favorite.
Wow.
I got to take the Gators, man.
That's an easy pick any day, man.
Kitty.
I mean, Lexington, they're 6-1, 5-1. What are, I mean, they've only lost
they're
a game.
They're 5-1, we're 6-1.
Yes.
They lost to West Florence. I see
who even is West Florence?
I see us exploiting their weaknesses. I'm thinking 31-21. That's my score pick.
All right.
The 3.5 line's a little sketch, but that's what Vegas is telling me. I'll take River Bluff every day of the week.
Jack, what do you think this week?
I'm also taking River Bluff any day. Easy cover. I take River Bluff. Score prediction, the Gators will win 31-13. Go Gators.
I like it. I'm not going to give my score prediction this week. I'll see you guys on Friday.
All right. Weston, respectable.
Can't go against the Gators. Cooper Johns, great O-line. I got Gators by 6.
All right. Hey, I got a special guest coming. This is my friend Andrew. Andrew. As you can see right here, we have our score predictions for this week. Do you have River Bluff or Lexington winning this Friday night?
Honestly, I got River Bluff.
All right, that's excellent. Do you have covering the spread of 3.5?
I go River Bluff, bro.
Excellent choice. That's only right.
We've got live Gator football players, AJ Coulter and Daniel. Make your way through here. Drew Surratt.
Excellent to have you guys.
Gators.
Look
we're
at all
live,
these Gators guys, live all these here. Fans.
What is the football team going to have to do this Friday to win against Lexington Wildcats?
I think we're going to have to stop the run.
I got one word.
Play hard, play tough.
And that word is compete every play. That's three words. Compete. But the one word is compete.
What's up with you? How you doing?
I like it, Drew. And I think that if we can compete this Friday night, we'll take the win too.
What do you think the key to winning this Friday night game is?
Staying together.
Excellent. Playing together is all it's about. I was at the volleyball game last night, and it honestly looked like just six different girls on one side of the court playing against our one team. It's just family's
playing
all that
together.
Matters.
Gators, that's all we have today for the live Gator game day in the Rotunda. And after everyone gave their predictions this week, we've got RB on top. But we'll see you guys Friday night. RB, let's go!
Yeah!
Let's go! We'll see you guys next time.
I would love our fans. Work hard, get smart, and do good. We'll be right back.